Hey friends, this is Wendy with Love and Stampin. I am so excited that you're here with me today because I am going to be showing you easy lights. These, well, all these lights, there's multiples, halo lights, easy lights. These are all from Pear Blossom Press, and I'm also going to be making a card featuring a beautiful stamp set from the rabbit hole. We're going to talk about this foam tape, and I'm going to show you this little cute card that I made at, check this out. This was a card that I made at the Scrapbook Expo. Look at that. It lights up. It lights up. So I kind of lied on this video when I said that this is my first time making a light up card, because I guess technically I made that one at the Scrapbook Expo, but this is my first time doing it all by myself and it not being a make and take. So, you know, it was a fib. All right. So we're using this Bunny Christmas stamp set from the Rabbit Hole Designs, and it comes with three dies to cut out the main images. And this is a really awesome set. I absolutely love this stamp set, and I had the best time making this card. So we're going to get into this. This has all kinds of cute little images. There is a car with a tree on top. There's a stack of presents with a little wand at the top. And then there's a bunny pulling a bunch of presents, all of which are adorable. So we're going to use the one with the gifts, where it's a big stack of gifts and the bunny rabbit on top. And we're going to color all of those beautiful little gifts. And we're going to make this super cute card. Okay, so for those who may want to know or have the question, when I come up with an idea for this card, I felt super nervous and overwhelmed about the light option. So I thought, okay, I'm going to just keep everything else about the card really simple. So I have a sentiment and an image, and that's where we're starting. So these are the one light easy lights, and they just, this one comes in a pack of three and they break apart like this. By the way, yes, there will be links to all of these products in the description below the video where it says measurements and supplies, or visit my blog at loveandstampin.com, and all of the supplies are listed on each blog post. So Amanda, who owns Pear Blossom Press, is the one who gifted me these gorgeous lights, and I am overjoyed at making light up cards now. Like, I can definitely see this is going to be something I'm going to do a lot of. So it comes with batteries, so you don't have to worry about batteries. And then there's three lights in that package, so they just break apart like you saw me do, and then they're ready to go. So what I did is I cut a piece of cardstock to 4 by 5 1/4. I'm going to use my mini Misty here, and I'm going to ink up this big giant stack of gifts with Hero Arts Intensified Black Ink. And then I'm going to color it with my Copic markers. So this stamp image is really adorable, and it's perfect for practicing coloring, and it was also perfect for making my first light up card because it's simple. Like, I don't have to worry about doing there. Now the lights, the Pear Blossom Press lights, they come so that like you can do like three separate little lights and tape them in different areas with one place to press. So it's really cool. There's lots and lots of options is what I'm getting at. And I will eventually be able to show you more cards, but for now, I just wanted to show you this. And that cute little purple masher that I'm using is from the Prickly Pear. And my friend Joy at Prickly Pear sent me that. Okay, so inking up again, because I wanted to make sure all my lines were nice and dark and ready for coloring. And then we're going to get busy coloring. For my color combinations, I decided to do a rainbow order for my gifts. And I went and looked at different places for ideas on how to color each color, color combinations. One of my very favorite places to go look is Instagram account and I don't know how to pronounce it. It's spelled, let me look it up. Let me, or I'll, I can link to it below, but it starts with L-O-S-H, I think. Yeah. It's L-O-S-H-A-K-E-R. So low shaker. A-T-O Alberto. So I don't know how to pronounce all of that. He's actually in Italy, and he is one of the most beautiful colorists. So anyway, just kind of fun to watch. All right, so back to the card. I stamped two of these because the design team that I'm on, Rabbit Hole Designs, she likes us to send her cards for like expos and stuff like that. But I have a really hard time parting with my cards because I like to use them and I don't want to wait to get them back. So I've decided I'm going to probably start doubling up everything I make so that if I send one off to Marianne, then I have another one for myself. And so, yeah, I, you know, just double up. And then when I get the ones back from her that I've made, I'll just have two cards to be able to send. So here I just doing my card bases. They're cut at 4 1/4 by 11, scored at 5.5. And you saw me there with the light under the cardstock and pushing it down because I was trying to think about how I was going to line all this up and figure it all out. So what I ended up doing is cutting a piece of Granny Apple Green cardstock, cut at 4 1/8 by 5 3/8. And I was trying to remember how they showed me to do this at the expo, and I think it was like this. you kind of put your light wherever it is you're going to want it on top of the card, then you remove the layer that's going to light up and try to kind of keep your little light in the same place. So I just kept testing this to make sure I had it all lined up correctly and was being super careful because I want his little wand to light up. So now I'm going to remove that and I'm going to keep this little guy in the same place, and I'm going to take my pencil and I'm going to go around all the edges with my pencil of where I want this to be. So then I can lift it up and I can add adhesive and glue it back down. So there is some thought process that has to go into this when you are making these cards, and I'm going to tell you why. Number one, you cannot block the light. So see how the light, when I push it down, it shines out the top. If I put the dimensional foam tape there, it's going to block it, and you'll just have like this little block of light instead of like a shining glowing light, if that makes sense. The light will still light up, but instead of it like kind of going out the top, it like blocks the light in. So I marked on my top layer where I need to put the word push, and there's some stamp sets available for that. And then you could put like push, press here, that kind of thing. And so I'm going to stamp that because that's important. People need to know where to push. Although we'll talk about giving these cards out here in just a second because I feel like instructions have to be done. So I'm going to stamp, I'm going to erase my little pencil mark, and I'm going to stamp the word push. And then we're going to go back to adding this layer to, well, that's not true. We have to color it first, then we're going to add the layer. But anyway, so I want to talk about the foam tape while I'm doing all of this. The foam tape that they sell at Pear Blossom Press is a double-sided foam tape, and it is thicker than normal foam tape so that your light mechanism will fit really well. Okay, it is also, this blew my mind, it is also repositionable for 30 minutes. 30 minutes. So for 30 minutes, you have time to readjust, move, pull up any cardstock layers that you use to adhere it together with. So here I'm just testing this out one more time. And then I'm going to add my adhesive, and then I'll just set this layer aside. Okay. So it's repositional for 30 minutes and it is totally secure by 24 hours. So probably could get away with even pulling it up like after the 30 minutes, but it might be stickier. So yeah. Anyway, I think that that's amazing. My mind was blown and I didn't know if that was real or not. I was like, I'm not so sure about this. When it says world's best foam tape, they're not lying. It doesn't stick down for 30 minutes. So you have all that time to move your stuff around if you need to. And there's a reason. This definitely takes some like thinking through how you're going to place things. And I'm going to give you an example. So when I went to put the foam tape around the edges of the white cardstock layer with the stamping, I ran into some trouble with the light, and I'm going to show you how to fix that. So right now we're going to skip to the coloring. So this is a new thing I'm doing. I'm mapping out my coloring. So I stamped my bunny rabbit and his gifts onto this grid paper from My Sweet Petunia. And I'm taking my pencil and I'm writing in what color each gift is going to be. Then I took my Sharpie and I wrote out all of my colors because I am finding that I have to do it that way in order to be able to sit and color on video with you with any sort of regularity. Otherwise, it's like I have to color one thing, stop the video, color another thing, stop the video, because I'm having to think about everything. So see here, I wrote out all the colors I need for red. You can screenshot this if you want. All the colors I need for orange, yellow, green, blue, and purple. So now I don't have to think about it. Now I can just sit and color and enjoy my time with you. And I don't have to think about, oh, well, which color this, which color that. I don't have to think about that. I can just color. And we're going to speed the video way up for the coloring because I am super slow. Like, I color so slow because I'm still learning. So it's just one of those things where in order for us to get through a video, this video was an hour and 10 minutes long. That's how long it took me to make this card. Now, that being said, when I made the second one, y'all, it was quick. I made it in like 35 minutes. And I did all the same things. I did the light. I did the coloring the same. I did everything. But because I had done it once and that fear was over of like, I'm going to mess it up, I don't know about the color combo, like all those things, those were over and done with. I just breezed through the second one. Like, it just was amazing. So I'm sharing that with you to say, the first time you do something that seems scary, right? Like this, where it seemed really scary to me to color all of these, to do the light thing. I was really overwhelmed by the idea of all of it at first. And then I just pushed through. I was like, just do it. You can do this, figure it out and do it. And I did. And I have to say, I'm really, really, really happy with my results. I love how these little gifts turned out. I love how the card turned out. The placement of the light was super easy. Like, all of it was way easier than I thought it would be. And so sometimes we just build stuff up in our head to be really complicated or stressful. And then we do it and it's like, oh, okay, that wasn't that bad. Kind of like going to the doctor or the dentist. I hate going to the doctor. And so every time I go, I build it up in my head like I'm never going to come back out of there. And then usually it's always a good report and it's not a big deal. So, you know, there's that. Okay, so I'm just going through each color, coloring each gift. And I know this isn't really traditional Christmas colors because rainbow, but I really wanted to play and color with a bunch of different colors. So that's how we ended up here. But you could do your stack of gifts all green and red, or, you know, keep it very Christmassy versus what I've done here, which is more, you know, I don't know, contemporary Christmas, non-traditional Christmas. So then what I did is I went back in and I used the complementary color on each gift. So complementary colors are colors that are opposite on the color wheel. So like red and green, purple and orange. They are not colors that go next to each other on the color wheel. Like if you were to mix purple and orange, it's going to make brown. If you were to mix green and red, it's going to make brown. So on the color wheel, they call them complementary colors, which because they complement each other in the way that they look, but they're not good for mixing together. So here I just kept with the purple for the yellow gift as well. And then at the top, I'm going to color the ribbon on those gifts green. For our little rabbit, I'm just going to color him in some warm grays and our little star in some yellows. And then the coloring aspect of this card is finished, except for the bottom. On the bottom, I used grays. I think I used warm grays to color kind of like something as if the presents were sitting on it. Now that I'm a little more confident in everything, I think I could have done a better job with the background, but that wasn't my focus for this card. The focus for this card for me was just having fun coloring, learning something new, and learning how to put this together. You see my little hand clap there? I clapped for myself. Yes, that happens sometimes in my craft room. So here we go with the foam tape. Now, let me walk you through this. When you use this foam tape, here's a mistake I made. You can, because the layer on top is it's an eighth of an inch smaller than the layer on the bottom. When I go to add this foam tape to the edges of this cardstock, I quickly realize when I go to put it down, oh, this isn't going to work because it's in the way of the light. So you'll see me get to remove and readhere this foam tape because remember, it's repositionable for 30 minutes. So I have an opportunity to show you that because it's just not going to work the way I put it down. So in my head, I was like, okay, just leave the top open. Because they did teach us that at the make and take at the Stamp and Scrapbook Expo. They taught us don't put like the foam tape above where your light is so that your light can escape. So when I go to put it down right here, see, I can't put it down. I'm like, oh, crap, because I have foam tape in the way over on that side. So yay, look at this. Repositionable foam tape, ta-da, peels right off. So I peel it back, I cut it, I place it back down, and I'm like, okay, now it's out of the way of the light mechanism. And now I'm just gonna cut a teeny tiny chunk, and I tested it, right? And now I'm just gonna cut a teeny tiny chunk to go in that upper corner near where the little wand is at. Because I want to obviously not have that like fold over on itself or like smush down. I still want it to be in place, but I'm trying to avoid blocking the light. So now we're going to remove the release paper off of the back of this card and we will add it back down to the Granny Apple green layer and it will be finished except for the sentiment. So as you can see, even though that took me a really long time to make this card in real life, most of that was taken up by the coloring. The actual putting together the light portion of this was super, super, super simple. Like anybody can do it, I promise. It does take just a tiny bit of planning, but it's not complicated. Like it's, I feel like, I mean, I've seen these cards where people do light up stuff 100 times. But I've always felt, there I am clapping for myself again. Oh, I'm so happy. Like I could not quit playing with this. I just had the best time pushing the button and clapping for myself. Oh my God, it's kind of embarrassing. Anyways, look at this, like a little child. Woohoo. I had to just keep doing it over and over and over. So let's talk about instructions. for this card, the little teeny tiny sentiment that is stamped on there that says push doesn't do the trick, people. Let me tell you how I know. My niece just had her 13th birthday, and I gave her the make and take card that I made at the Stamp and Scrapbook Expo, the one that I showed you at the beginning of this video. And I said to her, read the instructions, to which she was like, what instructions? Even though it said like press here. So finally I'm like, well, you got to push on it. So she just starts pushing all over the card. So I'm like, no, where it says to push. So what I'm thinking I'm going to do for these cards is I'm just going to type up some sort of cute little note that I can just pop on the front of any of these cards that I give away, because people are not going to intuitively know that they need to push on anything to make the card work. And it's too much like investment for time and money for the person not to use it correctly and get the joy out of lighting up the card. I mean, it's just so exciting, the light up. Now, they also sell some stuff that allows you to like open it up and replace batteries and stuff like that. I did get that. But anyway, super fun. The light up cards are super, super fun. So here for the sentiment, I stamped it and heat embossed it in white Hero Arts white fine detail powder. And now I'm just going to fussy cut it out with my paper snips, because I didn't like how bulky and big it was just cut out regular. I wanted it to be like smaller, especially because I went to the trouble for all of the coloring of those gifts. I certainly did not want this giant sentiment to like take over and cover everything up. So I went ahead and fussy cut this whole thing out, and then we're going to add it on. I can't remember if I put it on dimensionals or if I just glued it flat down. Now, to be honest, we're going to find out together. So that is the card today, you guys. I really hope you enjoyed this, because this was such a fun card to make. And if you want to get some of these lights to try out, you can get them at the link in the video description. I am not an affiliate. I have requested to become an affiliate of Pear Blossom Press because they sell lights and Stampin' Up! Doesn't sell those. But I don't know if they're going to approve it or not. And, you know, that is what it is. So for now, for the time being, I'm not an affiliate, but I think that Amanda has a beautiful product and she's a very sweet person, and you should definitely grab some of those lights. And then with this stamp set, a little bunny told me that this stamp set might be going away. So if you like this stamp set from the Rabbit Hole Designs, you definitely want to grab this stamp set before it's gone. And it's just so cute. All the bunnies are so cute. And the gifts, I just love it. I love the artwork for these images. They're just really my style. I like clean and simple graphic lines, and I love cute little animals. Those just always make me happy. And I think that's it. We don't really have time for an in-depth story time today. Life is good. Things are plugging along, and I hope that you are planning to have a really good weekend. We are going to a water polo awards banquet tonight. And we kind of have a relaxed weekend other than that. So I'm looking forward to that. All right, here's the finished card. And I think I add maybe a little, yep, added a little bling from the rabbit hole. Some little shaker bits. They're like little rhinestones and crystals. And so I added those. And I'm using my crystal katana to add those. And that's it. And I really wanted to give you a shout out. Thank you to everybody who uses my links to purchase. If I'm not an affiliate, it doesn't matter. But for those of you that do purchase using links that are affiliate links of mine, I really, really appreciate it. It means a lot to me. And I appreciate all your support. Like I did the video with my nail polish stuff the other day, I don't know, it was a little bit ago, and so many of you were so kind and was like, this is fun, we like this. And I mean, I won't be doing nail polish videos all the time, but it was just a one-off, and you were all so supportive and loving, and that's what I love about this community. So anyway, look at, ta-da, how cute. I just love it. I had the best time making this card. I hope you guys grab some of these lights and grab this stamp set because it's adorable. And I'll catch you in the next video. If you need any supplies from me from Stampin' Up, you can shop loveandstampin.com. All the other links for everything else are at the description below this video where it says measurements and supplies. Thanks for tuning in, and I'll catch you in the next video. Bye-bye.